That was a lot of great stuff.
Richard Maddock, M-A-T-T-I-C-K. Deputy Chief, City of Sandy Fire Department. We responded to the report of a structure fire. Units en route reported large column smoke coming from the structure. First unit on scene reported that there was heavy fire and smoke throughout the structure. As we attempted to make an attack on the fire, the main part of the fire appeared to be out the back of the building, and then it quickly spread to the interior of the structure. Our truck company went up the roof to cut the ventilation holes as we attempted to make entry to the front door to extinguish the fire. In addition, we had a couple companies around the back part of the structure to ensure that the heck of a fluid of the structure was a threat. It took a little while for us to get inside and actually point where the fire was, so we eventually got to it and had it knocked down out of the fire.
Talk about how difficult it is. It's a one-way road in here.
It's a one-way road in here, so first apparatus comes in, tends to kind of plug it up a little bit. Obviously, everybody else has to park back behind them. But I think part of the problem was initially determining exactly where this fire was. Because, again, as soon as we first got here, the fire pretty much throughout the house.
House occupied?
No, well, I don't know if the house is occupied. We got an initial report that the people were out of the house. I think that there were some people originally in the house when the house first caught on fire. I heard a report that the occupant had a fire in the fireplace. They'd gone outside for a little bit. She came back in, looked in one of the children's room. At that time, one of the walls was completely involved in fire.
How many injuries?
We did have injuries. Two minor injuries. The firefighters burned. They were transported to the hospital for observation. We expect to be able to do this very shortly.
Any other difficulties in trying to determine?
No, the biggest difficulty began with just trying to determine exactly where the scene of fire was. In many instances, it's pretty clear it's in one room or another. Here it was a little bit challenging because it had a pretty quick spread, and many portions of the interior structure were on fire when it arrived.
You got a money value or oxygen replacement at the process?
Now, at this point, it looks like we're probably going to estimate this at about $300,000 damage. We don't really have a specific cause or origin of fire yet. We have requested the San Diego Sheriff's Office, Bomb and Arson, to come out and assist us with the investigation. No, to my knowledge, there were no propane cylinders or anything that's been found here. I believe that they're all on natural gas. I'm not sure, but I think everybody is on natural gas. But I had no report. Well, we don't know for sure again. The information we got from Johnson was that she came back in the house and helped open the door in the children's room, opened the door, and saw one of the whole walls involved.
A lot of injuries.
Yes, as a matter of fact, on this, we did call a second alarm on this. We had approximately 9 apparatus, that's the truck, along with 7 engines, 2 medic units, and approximately 4 to 5 chief officers.
Is there any reason why it was so much of a large response for a half hour?
I'm sorry?
Why was the large response for this kind of fire?
The large response was due to the fact that we did have trouble getting to the fire to get it. Right away. Time went along, the fire seemed to spread a little bit. So we had to call the additional units.
Did you stop to respond? I saw San Diego, San Miguel, Lakeside.
Yeah, I know we had San Diego, Lakeside, Heartland Fire Investigators,